Hey everyone, Mitchell from MitchellGould.com, and in today's video, we're going to be installing the LinkedIn Ads Insight tag. We're going to be using Google Tag Manager to do that. And before we install the Insight tag, we're actually going to be installing Google Tag Manager onto a WordPress site. So if you already have Google Tag Manager set up, you can use the chapters below to skip ahead into the video to the part where we're actually installing the Insight tag via Google Tag Manager. So let's go ahead and get started. I have my LinkedIn Ads account pulled up here, and I'm first gonna go over to Analyze on the left. We're gonna click Insight Tag. The Insight Tag is used for conversion tracking, so you can measure things like form submits on your website. You can also use it to create retargeting audiences based off of people that visited your site. And you can also use it to see demographic information of LinkedIn's members. So you can see things like company name, job functions, industry, when you have enough data to meet those thresholds. So we'll click Create Insight Tag. We're gonna go ahead and agree to their terms. And the option that we're gonna be using is to use Tag Manager. You can also install the tag yourself directly into your website's code. Typically, a lot of clients, they already have Google Tag Manager, so I tend to use that. So if we click Google Tag Manager, you'll see our partner ID here, which we'll use. But before we set anything up with the Insight Tag, we're gonna be installing Google Tag Manager onto my website. So if we go over into my WordPress dashboard for that site, we're gonna need a plugin. So I'm gonna go to plugins and we're gonna go ahead and add a new plugin. And you're gonna search for insert headers and footers. So we're gonna go ahead and use this plugin here and we're gonna click install. And then we can go ahead and click activate. So this brings us into our plugin section. We'll find WP headers and footers, and we'll go ahead and click settings. And then from here, we're gonna go and set up a Google Tag Manager account. So you can just Google Tag Manager, and you can use your Gmail account to sign into it and create an account. I'm already signed in, and because I already have accounts created for some of my other clients, I'm already in this section. So we'll go ahead and click Create Account. And it's pretty straightforward. You just have to give it a name. I'll say Mitchell's account here. I'm based in the United States. We'll leave that unchecked. And then we'll want to give the container a name. We'll go ahead and click target platform for web because we're doing this on a website. And we'll click create. We'll go ahead and accept the terms. Once that's created, it's going to show the code that needs to be installed onto the website. We'll go ahead and copy this code that needs to be pasted in the head of our website. So we'll click copy. And then we go to our WordPress plugin, we go into the scripts in the header section, we can paste that in, and then we can go back to Tag Manager and copy the code that needs to be pasted in the body section. So we'll click copy, go back to our WordPress plugin, go to scripts in body and paste that in there. And then you scroll down to the bottom and click save changes. So it says settings have been saved. And then what we do is we can click OK here. If you ever need to get back to that section, you just have to click the container ID here and those codes will pop back up. So now that we have Google Tag Manager installed on our website, we'll go ahead and create a new tag for the LinkedIn Ads Insight tag. So in Google Tag Manager, you'll want to go over to the left and click tags, and then you'll click create new. And then we can call this our LinkedIn Insight tag. And then we can go to tag configuration. We'll click that. And then where it says choose tag type, just below that it says discover more tag types and community template gallery. So we'll click that and we need to search for LinkedIn. And you'll see this LinkedIn Insight Tag 2.0 by LinkedIn. So we'll click that and we'll import that in and click add to workspace, click add. So that's our tag. And then we have to add our partner ID here. So we go back into LinkedIn. And under I will use Tag Manager, you'll see your partner ID. We click that and copy it. We go back into Tag Manager and we paste that in. You can scroll down if you need to. We'll go to the triggering section now. This is just gonna tell Tag Manager when this tag should fire. And we want this tag to fire on all pages. So if you click triggering, you'll see this page view trigger here, all pages. It's automatically in Google Tag Manager and we have it named, we have our tag set up, we know it's gonna fire on all pages and we click save. After that's saved, we can go to the preview section. This will just help us troubleshoot and ensure that the tag is firing. We'll add our website, click connect, and then we'll go back to this Tag Assistant tab, hit continue. And you can see here in the tags fired section, we have our LinkedIn Insight tag. So we know that it's fired, which is great. We'll go back into Google Tag Manager and we'll click Submit. And now this is going to publish that tag live onto our site. For the version name, we can say added Insight tag. This is just for your own understanding when you're looking at, you know, past changes in your Google Tag Manager. We know at this time is when we added our Insight tag. We'll click Publish, and now that tag has been published to the site. The last thing we want to do is go back to our site, refresh our site, and you'll want to download a Chrome extension. It's called the B2B House LinkedIn Insight Tag Checker. This is going to be our final verification that the tag is actually installed on our site. And once you have that Chrome extension enabled, you can click Inspect, and there you can see our Insight Tag Checker, our partner ID is right there, and that's our same partner ID that we copied and put in our tag. So once you've verified that the tag is working properly using that Chrome extension, you're all set. Your LinkedIn Insight tag is installed successfully onto your page. You can begin creating retargeting audiences based off of website visitors. You can use that to create conversion tracking, which we'll look in a future video. In the description, I'll put the links in for our Google Tag Manager, for that Chrome extension, for the WordPress plugin if you need to use that. And if you have any questions, put them in the comment section, even if they're not related. I'd love to, you know, be able to help you out. So go ahead and just post any questions there. Thank you for watching and have a great day.